Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world, and welcome to Keypoint Intelligence interviews with what's trending in packaging and labels. Today, I've got a very special guest, and I don't think he needs this big introduction because everybody knows that Jim Continenza is the CEO that is leading the Kodak comeback. So welcome, Jim.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Thank you. So, Jim, you sat on the Kodak board before you took the position as CEO. I know that you've got this big history of actually turning companies around. What was the driving force that made you take on this Kodak challenge?
Well, initially, I was put on the board when the company was still in their bankruptcy and restructuring. And I was put on to help get them out because I've had some experience and I knew some of the debt holders. And to me, you know, Kodak is such an iconic name and brand, and it's just part of world history, not just America. And I just couldn't, you know, see this brand go away. It just was really important to me that this brand live on. And that was really kind of enticing to me at the time. I didn't know what I was getting into, but it was very enticing.
Yeah, we never do when you do something like that, I'm sure. But, oh, well, you seem to be on track. So that's fantastic. So, Jim, I want to go through Kodak's journey into the packaging markets. And in June, you launched your Ascent Press. But Kodak is not new into packaging. So do you want to give me a bit of a history in Kodak's journey into the packaging market?
Yeah, it's also in print, right? If you look at Kodak today, we had to re-identify ourselves. And we kind of did that three and a half years ago. You know, I asked the question, what is Kodak? And I got many answers. And we had to narrow it down to what really is Kodak. We're coating, layering, right, which is really advanced materials and chemicals. And then we are print. So I call it print, advanced materials, and chemicals. We call it AMC. And the technology in AMC really drives everything we do in the print and packaging. It's the technology in our inks, the ability to make such fine inks that we can run some high speeds and also put inks down, water-based inks on oil-based products. So it's into our AMC working with our print division. And at one time, you know, we had the flexographics division that we have spun off and sold. So we had, you know, insight into that. I see Kodak moving more towards the digital print. So fortunately for us, we don't have to eat our own business, you know, which in plates we do, right? Go back to traditional print. I sell plates and CTPs that I just launched, you know, the world's fastest printing machine, the Prosper 7000, and it beat the other fastest machine, which was the Prosper 6000. It's 30% faster. And then we just launched the 520, and that goes right at plates. So there I'll be trading off plates for digital print. I'm fortunate now as we invest in digital packaging, and we see that as a trend in future with our new UltraStream heads and the inks that we've come up with. For us, I won't at least be replacing my own business. I'll be getting new business, which I think is really important to grab that new business versus having the same dilemma. And Kodak's seen it before, film, digital, right? They've lived this already. You know, we don't want to make those same mistakes. So if we have to, you know, cannibalize some of our own business to move into the future, it's about our customers. And, you know, Gene, we didn't really talk about the biggest change inside of Kodak is we put a customer first model in place and a one Kodak. And what does that mean? It means there's one Kodak. There were eight divisions doing whatever they want. It wasn't around the customer. Everything we do is around the customer. We have councils put up. We have analysts on calls. We have our top 20 customers on a call every quarter guiding us on our products. We're not making products and asking them to use them or selling. We're hearing from them and building products that make them more profitable. We only win if our customer sells. Think about it, right? If they don't build and sell packaging, we don't make any money either. We don't sell anything. So we really changed our model to how do we support our customers and help grow their business. And that's where you're seeing like the ascend in the drive into packaging. It's a growing market. It is with Amazon, eBay, Facebook, you know, marketplace. Many people can open a small business and sell online today. And packaging has just grown, not just packaging in the stores. So we see that as an opportunity and we want to continue to play. And we want some of our commercial ink customers to move into that packaging space because they can. It's that local packaging in their area. And the Ascend allows them to do that. And we also built a much larger digital packaging machine with Uteco as a partner called the Evo and Evo Wide, which uses Stream and UltraStream, which is amazing. It literally is a true competitor to Flexographics. Probably more than you want to know.
Partnership. No, that's an exciting partnership. That's so great. So just getting to the SM press, what are some of the great features and the differentiators that this press has actually got? Because I know that you've got great embellished ink capabilities and dry ink foil. So can we get into a bit more detail about that?
I mean, we get feedback from our field, right? And we had a couple of our text. Diego was one of them. In my Granada, they came to me. I was building a different machine, I'll be really candid with you. And they came to me and they said, look, we have an opportunity here because we invented some new oilless toners. And they looked at one of our platforms and they said to me, I know we want these other machines, but this makes sense. I didn't know much about the point of sale equipment. That isn't an area I knew much about. I do some of the packaging from other previous experiences, and it was really interesting. And you got to listen to your people. And when they came to me and said, look, we could take this machine and go to a heavy substrate. We can take this machine, go to 48 inches wide. We can take this machine, right, and actually do embellishments and do embossment. We can also take the machine and do foil, true foil, not silver paint. And it makes a difference, and do small packaging and signage for stores. And make it more universal. Will it do 100% of what a UV machine does? Not at all. But will it do a nice piece of that market, a larger portion? Absolutely. And at about a tenth of the cost, and much higher speed and great quality. And I let them run with it. And to their credit, with Randy, they devised these machines. They came back and said, we can build this. And they turned this machine out in approximately about a year, even during a pandemic. And it really hits that 30-point paper, that 48 inches wide, that point of sale, that beautiful box, the other type of embellishments and embossment, all in line. And it's quite a machine, and we're really happy. It's built off of the next Affinity platform, which we have a lot of experience with. And the new oilless toners helped us do that. So it opens up new channels for our partners, commercial printers, to sell.
And that's a great opportunity, because I think commercial printers right now, everybody's looking at how do I put my toe into packaging and step into that water. So this is a great entry level, is it not?
It is, Gene. And if you look at really where, you know, margins have gone, label companies have done very well. Look at the multiples of a label company versus a print company. You know, label companies are trading at 6 and 10, and that's because they bring in great margin. Print companies are trading at 2, 3, and 4. So it's very interesting. The value creation they can bring within their business in looking at these other components. And the Ascend helps you do that now, helps you get into the growing markets, not just the traditional print markets.
It's exciting, yeah. Now, the burning question I've got to ask is obviously, you know, why didn't you use the incredible inkjet technology that Kodak has for the Ascend press? Or is this because of the Nexfinity sort of relationship there?
So when you get into what the Ascend does, you're talking about embellishments, you're talking about, you know, embossments, that's layering and coating. You really got to use a more granular substance in a water-based ink to stack it. So it really comes through the, you know, toners versus the inks. It's a different technology, and it really isn't the right one for that. It doesn't mean we won't have a point of sale that does things differently with it, because UltraStream is our future. We know that. We invest a lot of money after Stream, which was, you know, unbelievable. UltraStream gives us even more flexibility. I mean, Gene, the head's this big. It has 2,600 jetty modules in it, right? It's up to almost a billion droplets a second. It's just very fine, perfectly round. The qualities, so that quality through the roof allows us to stack it up to 96 inches wide. We have a lot of flexibility with that head that'll allow us to do other things.
So basically, you're going to be ticking all the boxes once you have all the presses sitting on that press room floor, huh?
Which it's is fantastic. Not either or, Jean, right? It's both. Yeah. Depends both. If you want to do this and you want to do that.
Yeah. They complement each other in a lot of ways, don't
Correct.
They?
They don't overlap.
So if you look at sort of Kodak, you've been a long sort of leader in the hybrid printing, direct mail, lottery applications with your Prosper S-Series imprinting system. So what about the hybrid printing for folding cartons, flexible packaging, track and trace and labels? Can you give me a bit more insight into that? Those vertical markets.
I smile. I was recently chairman of a company we sold called Sinveo. They're in envelopes and labels. So I'm very familiar with the envelopes business and the labels business. And what a great management team. They did a phenomenal job. We just sold the company. And I learned a lot from them on the label side. So, you know, we will continue to look into that space. And we've put several beta machines out there now. And we're now past control introduction. Been running them for a couple of years. And we're ready to go full throttle now. Uteco's done a great job on the transport. And our head's integrated very well. It's been a very good partnership.
So is that the whole GDM partnership? Or is that a separate one? So how does that sort of play into the whole strategy?
Yeah, an example, we're printing on diapers and femcare, right? Irritations you can't have, right? That's really where we're using these types of technology. So those inks just make the machines that much broader and our portfolio broader on different substrates. So when you see that type of information, that just means we're broadening the substrates that we can print on and making more options and flexibilities.
So basically, I mean, your environmentally friendly water-based inks and that are used in those particular applications.
Right. Look, at, you know, we take, we and the company, I also take sustainability very seriously, Gene. That's a big one for me. And you'll see the push in Sonora, our process-free plates, right? We've invested heavily in those and they have grown through the roof now. It's by far the best plate on the market. Uses water in the processing of plates, not 13 or 14 extremely harsh chemicals that we make, by the way.
Sure.
It's one of those. You got to get rid of water-based inks. But, you know, water-based inks doesn't mean it's just better. It's also what you blend them with, right? If you take water-based inks and put poisonous products with them, you've done no good.
Exactly.
So we've been very careful with that. And we take sustainability really seriously. We did a whole sustainability study. We also live it within our park. I hunt, I fish, I'll be candid with you. I like clean water. I live in the northern part of the United States. You know, my lake I live in has 27 feet of clarity. See, that's what water is to me. It should be that clear. And so I really have a burning desire to do it, sustain, you know, to drive sustainability, but also do it in the right timing and help transform the businesses there. But yeah, we stay with the water-based inks. We stay with the process-free plates. We do make wet plates, but we keep moving over to the process-free. It's a really big part of it. We want to help clean up the industry and lead it. And Kodak's going to live it internally in our manufacturing. And it's bigger than that. We look at the carbon footprint, right? Go back to carbon. You know, think what it takes to make an aluminum plate. They got to mine the ingot. They got to then ship it, then you got to smelt it, then you got to bring it to the manufacturer of the lithium grade, then you got to ship it to us, and we got to run it through, turn it into a plate. That's a lot of carbon being used versus a digital printhead, and then those chemicals that go with it. So we're really looking at all of it, not just, you know, the water-based things. What's the carbon being used for the products that we're selling and the products we can transfer to?
Positive stuff. So well done.
My team really believes in it. This isn't just, it's the easiest thing you could ever drive.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And you know what? It's something everybody's going to be aware of right now because everybody's, you know, it's on everybody's list. And it's just nice to see what you're actually doing about it. So as I said, I read your blog and quite impressive. So well done on that.
Gene, I have three children. We have to leave a planet to them and other children's and other people's children, right? We got to do the right thing. So.
And you know what, as you say, sometimes when it's so close to home and you right. are a water lover, you're seeing it all the time and you're seeing what damage it's actually doing. So I get what you're saying. I understand.
It's at Kodak, right? I've said something. I always tell my people this. When we got here, I made a few commitments. One of them, we will leave this company better than when I got here. We will create jobs for the next generation. We'll create shareholder value, right? That's also with the planet. We have to leave it for the next generation. It all flows with the same concept that you put into your company.
So like your way of thinking. Awesome. So great leader, clearly. So Jim, let's just talk quickly about production efficiency. How does the whole Prinergy workflow actually fit into this picture now?
So that's a great question. We're reinvesting and rewriting Prinergy. Obviously, we add the Microsoft suites to it, which broaden the interface and the products and its flexibility for the printer. But more importantly, right, we went cloud-based, not server-based. So we have cloud and server, but we're moving more to the cloud. We've instituted AI inside of it. So our printers can run more efficient, less ink, less energy, you know, things like that. And also help run their business more efficiently. And we're going to keep investing in it and broaden it. Now we're on the pre-press side of it. And then there's post-press software. And we got to make sure that those two work hand in hand to bring that efficiency through the whole food chain. And we're willing to do that and open that up. So it's been a real investment. We brought in an individual named Jim Barnes to rewrite it. and his team, and we're taking that next step. It's a great product. We're going to make it better, and it's going to do more for our printers. And again, we get feedback from our customers, and they're helping us guide the next generation of product. But it's time for a refresh, not just cloud-based. It'll do a lot more, and we're excited about the new product suite.
So, Jim, I think that sort of brings us to the end of our time, and it's been an absolute honor and a pleasure to talk to you, and just so encouraging to see a leader that's almost leading, well, that is leading by example, and definitely seeing you making huge changes there, and very excited to see what's to come. And so thank you for your time. It's been an absolute pleasure, and hopefully not the last either. We'll be chatting a lot more, I think, with new things that you've got on the cards, I'm sure.
I really appreciate you taking the time to take a look at Kodak and giving us the opportunity to tell our story. But this isn't about Jim Continenza. It's about my people. I have an unbelievable leadership team, and I really do. And they're the ones driving it. I do probably the least in the company, and that's not a humble statement. It's actually true. So.
And it always starts at the top. So you clearly filter down, because you have got an excellent motivated team. And I know quite a few of the players there. Everybody's angry and wants to make it happen. So clearly there's a great driver there.
Great. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you for your time.